Okay. Then the third type is fragmentation. As the name suggests, fragments means they will break down into small pieces. So in this, the body breaks into distinct pieces or fragments, and each fragment grows into an adult capable of producing offsprings. Now you see, this is the hydra. Now this hydra has been broken down into two pieces. Now each piece, children, please mark my words, that each piece will regenerate the part which it is not having. Okay, again I am telling you, each piece will regenerate the part which it is not having or the part which is missing. Like here in the first part, the end portion is missing, so it has developed the end portion. But in the second part, the upper portion is missing, so it has developed that. Now both of them are two new individuals which are formed from one hydra. Similarly, here in the diagram, see planaria. This is planaria. Now it has been divided into three pieces. So each piece is developing the parts which are missing. Now the first one was not having the lower portion, so it has been replaced. The middle one was not having even the front part or the lower part, so both of them have been regenerated. And here the third one was not having the topmost part, so it has been regenerated. And now from three pieces, three individuals are formed. So this is fragmentation in planaria or hydra. Next type of asexual is vegetative propagation. This also we have done in class 7th, if you remember. Why do we call it as vegetative propagation? Propagation is almost reproduction. It is reproduction. But why vegetative? Because here the vegetative parts of the plant are used for producing the new individuals. Now, who are the vegetative parts? The root, the stem, the leaf. These are the vegetative parts of the plant. Who are the reproductive parts? Flower is the reproductive part of the plant. Now we all know that reproductive part has the function of reproduction. That though is fixed, that reproductive part will do the function of reproduction. But when vegetative part also are used for propagation or for producing new progenies, then we call it as vegetative propagation or asexual type of reproduction. Now here you see there are so many examples given in front of you. These are the eyes of potato. You see here rhizome of ginger, bulbils of agave, leaf buds of bryophyllum here, offsets of water hyacinth. Now it is the production of offsprings from vegetative part in the plants. Vegetative propagules are the units of vegetative propagation. Now here the vegetative propagule is the eye. Here the vegetative propagule is rhizome. In this case it is bulbil. In this case the leaf is the vegetative part from which the new plants are grown up. And here the offsets, these are the offsets, the swollen ones, these are the offsets which are actually the vegetative part of the plant, and these are used for the production of new progenies. Now children, let me tell you one important thing. This is very, very important, this slide. Okay, now here the bud or the eyes of potato tuber, rhizome of banana and ginger. Buds and rhizomes arise from the nodes of modified stem. Now children, stem, what is the function of stem? Stems have the function of anchorage. That is, they help the leaf, the flower, the fruits to get attached. They are attached on the stem. And second thing is, stem helps the plant to stand straight or for the anchorage. But beyond that, stem is also used for propagation. So each stem is having nodes and internodes. You know what is node? The portion or the place where a leaf is attached, that part is called node. And what is internode? The space between two nodes. Excuse me. The space between two nodes is known as internode. node. Now what happens is the nodes come in contact with damp soil. Not well, what I do is, if I suppose you must have seen sugar cane, children, you must have seen sugar cane. Now sugar cane has a stem and it has such kind of lines. You must have seen sugar cane. The lines are present on the stem of sugar cane. Now these lines are actually the nodes. Now what happens when this node comes in contact with the soil? This is soil and the soil is damp, that means it is having a lot of moisture. Now when this node comes in contact with the soil on water, it produces roots. The roots are developed from here. The node, from here the roots are developed and new plants are developed from here. So these are the nodes from where the new plants will arise. Okay, next we come to adventitious buds of bryophyllum. As you see here in the diagram, these are the buds of bryophyllum. See, these are the buds of bryophyllum. Now they arise from the notches. These are the notches from where they are arising. These are the notches, okay, on the bryophyllum leaf, of on the margins of the leaves. Now wherever these will fall, they will give rise to a new plant of bryophyllum. Next is bulbil of agave. This is bulbil of agave. This can also generate into a new plant. Offset of water hyacinth. These are the offsets. This line is the offset of water hyacinth. These may give rise to a new plant. Beyond that, sucker, runner, tuber, bulb. These are also the vegetative parts from which a new plant can be generated. So you see, so many parts are there from which you can generate a new plant. You can make a new plant from stem, you can make a new plant from root, you can make a new plant from leaf, from bulb, from offset, from runner, from sucker, from tuber, from any part. So that is why this is called vegetative propagation. Okay, I hope this is clear. Another thing that I want to discuss, this last part, is asexual reproduction, is zoospores. Now children, zoospores are microscopic. Why do we call them microscopic? Because they are not visible through naked eyes. They are motile, that means they can move. You see, they are having flagellas, so they can move in some alga and protista. Examples of zoospore is Chlamydomonas. This is Chlamydomonas. Then we come to conidia. These are other reproductive structures, conidia. Now this is penicillium. These are conidias. Wherever these conidias will fall, they will give rise to a new plant. Penicillium is a fungus and the reproductive structure of this penicillium is conidia. Similarly, the reproductive structure of sponge is gemmule. As I already told you, this is sponge, gemmule. So asexual reproduction is common method in simple organisms like algae and fungi during adverse condition. Now children, what do you mean by adverse conditions? Conditions when things are not good, there is no availability of food or water, or temperature is too high. So they shift to sexual method. That means वैसे तो they do asexual reproduction. These smaller organisms or these unicellular simpler organisms, they always follow asexual reproduction. But if conditions are not good, if conditions are adverse, they can shift from asexual method to sexual method. Higher plants reproduce asexually or vegetative and sexually both, but most of the animals show only sexual reproduction. Right, so this much is a lot we have done for today. Next we will discuss about the sexual reproduction in the next video.